Business.
Hello.
Daddy, here's the key.
Thank you, baby. What is up, everybody? You already know how it goes. It's your boy B back with another video. Thank you guys so much for watching and tuning in. If you are, first of all, just seeing me, my name is Brandon Jones, and I specialize in helping you make an extra income. If you are returning, of course, guys, you already know I got your back like a bra strap. And we just here talking, and I'm showing you guys my life as an entrepreneur. Now, guys, I first need you guys to make sure you are having a productive day. And I want to share with you guys something that is actually weighing on me. When I started this channel, one of my main focuses was not to make money from it, but instead it was to show the journey, document the journey, show the journey of me just being an entrepreneur, so that you guys could see it, other people can see it that doubt themselves. My kids can see it when they become entrepreneurs or whatever they want to do. But I think all of us have its trials and tribulations and things that go on in our life that can distract us from just being the best version of ourselves, right? And this is like one of the most raw videos I've ever shot, because I just picked up a camera. I was thinking about making a nice fancy setup and making it dramatic, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm going to actually bring you guys me. I've been in the bed all day. I'm not gonna lie. Well, not all day. I took Hustle out for a walk. I rode bikes with my friend. I just was taking some me time because I really, really needed it. And the reason I needed it was because of the title and because of what you guys see. And what I won't do, I will not throw anybody under the bus. I won't say any names or anything like that. But one thing I will do is I will share this experience with you guys, even though it's sort of kind of something that till this day sits with me, and something I really, really, I just despise it and just hate that it happened. But at the end of the day, you chalk it up to the game. And it's a part of life, especially as an entrepreneur. You have a very fragile, you have a very fragile tolerance for a lot of things when you're an entrepreneur, and plus a parent, plus in a relationship, plus just paying a lot of people's, helping people pay a lot of their bills, obviously. And you have a lot of responsibility, and it's hard to really gauge your personal life and take care of that as well, right? So I am going to tell you guys how, you know, I got cheated on while working on my business, while having all the money, while having somebody just benefit off of it, while being able to technically do what I want, as far as, you know, not having any restrictions, having free time. I ain't gonna say when, only because I don't want to hurt anybody. I don't want it to be any type of like shot towards anyone. This is something I gotta tell you guys, because I know for a fact it's somebody that may be going through this, right? Number one, as an entrepreneur, being in a relationship is extremely difficult. The reason I say being in a relationship is extremely difficult is because me being in a relationship with somebody is so hard, because I care about my business more than I care about a lot of things, right? My business is my first baby, and my business is something I've literally been working on since I was, 17? And it's something I focus on, and something that I hold very, I hold above a lot of things besides my kids, of course. But it's hard being in a relationship because usually the woman wants to be put first, and usually the woman, they have emotions, and they have needs, right? And I'm okay with them having needs. I'm okay with them, you know, needing certain things from me. But at some point, it's like I gotta lock in, right? I gotta lock into my work, because if you want to keep living and not having to go to work and just relaxing, working on your stuff, I gotta work. You know what I mean? I gotta stay focused. And it's hard because when you're an entrepreneur, you need a female that's going to understand the goal, understand that mission, understand your strategy to achieving the goal that you have set, including them in it, and telling them exactly what role you need them to play and having them comply with it. You need that. And if you don't have it and you have somebody consistently being rebellious, argumentative, just non-compliant, or somebody that is looking at you like, if you can do it, I can do it, so I'm just going to try and do it myself, that's when a lot of issues come to play, because it's no longer you guys operating as a team. So what happened to me was, me continuing to be as productive as possible and focusing on my job and my work, I was literally laying next to somebody that was texting and having dealings with someone else. Now, the person obviously is going to say, I didn't do anything with this person and da-da-da-da-da. But at the same time, as somebody that is putting everything out for the complete well-being of the team, it is so difficult for you as an entrepreneur or as a human in general, giving your all, to realize that you were giving your all and somebody was basically giving you 25% and other percent to somebody else. And at that time it hurt, because I was working on myself and I was working on my business, and it sort of kind of seems, and even to this day, that every time I'm thriving in my business and I'm laser focused, it's something that has to come and distract you, right? It's something always, and you are going to go through it too. If you are an aspiring entrepreneur, or if you're an entrepreneur already, you already know that it may seem like glitter and gold from the outside, but the inside, we got communication problems because we don't know how to communicate to people most of the time. We have problems explaining ourselves and showing emotion because we don't show that to people sometimes, most of the times. And then we have problems with time management and putting everybody in a position to feel like they're included. So, you know, before anything, I hold myself accountable. Because if I would have made that person feel secure, well, more secure, I don't know how, you know, I mean, paying all the bills and everything, I feel is making somebody feel some type of secureness. But at the same time, I got to take accountability, because if I don't make somebody feel emotionally secure, then I have to deal with the consequences or whatever they got going. And the main story and portion of this video, if you're still watching, that I want you to take apart, is the most important, is that if you are an entrepreneur, or if you're somebody inspiring to be an entrepreneur, what I want you to do is, I never want you to lose sight of your goal and your dream. No matter who you with, if it's your baby mom, if it's a girlfriend, if it's a, I don't even care, whoever it is that's close to you, understand these people close to you that may be benefiting off of the things that you, you know, do as well. You need to understand that you can never let somebody knock you off of your ladder you've been building forever, right? Because sometimes we can act irrational when we're upset, especially when we're already under pressure building businesses or dealing with customers or creating something. We always deal with pressure, right? And that pressure can sometimes feel as if we just can't withstand it, right? And we want to give up. There's no point of giving up. There's no point of feeling less than what you are. Understand that you are everything you need to be. And no matter what you go through, no matter what people put you through, no matter what you put people through, that doesn't define you in this moment. And the only thing that defines you in this moment is the way that you act in this moment. So whether you have a relationship issues, family issues, whatever issue you have, right? Understand, you are the you're literally the thermometer, and think of everybody around you as just adapting to the temperature that you set, right? So we have to understand that we have to be that leader, and sometimes leaders have scars and just hide them and keep it pushing. And I'm not saying do that all the time. I'm not saying keep things hidden or keep the pain within, but what I am saying is don't let that pain make you act irrational and forget that you got 11 phone goal that you need to get and buy and flip, or don't forget that you have to go and clock in and open the store, or don't forget that you have to pay payroll. Don't forget, or don't be so tied up in depression or distraction that you forget that other people are literally looking at you and trying to live and survive, and you put yourself in a position to literally give that to them. And you can't let somebody knock you off your square. You can't let somebody make you feel less than what you are. And the reason I said that, guys, is because I've been in a dark place before. A very dark place before, to where I just wanted to just end it all, right? But then what I realized is forgiveness is powerful, but also understanding who and how, well, who you are and how to love yourself is very important. So that's just something I really wanted to share with you guys, because at that point when this all happened, I wanted to give up. You know, I just wanted to just say, you know what, forget it, I'm over it. I just want to sulk and be, you know, down on myself. But you can't do that. You got to stand up for yourself and understand who you are. And if it's their loss, it's their loss. You can't be tripping on nobody else's loss. Just say, all right, see you later, and keep it pushing. So hopefully this sits with somebody that needs it. Because we all need somebody to have our back sometimes, you know? And I'm here for you guys. So I hope you guys have a great day whenever you're seeing this. And continue to go, man. Don't let nobody stop you. You got this. Peace.